Hi, welcome. My name is Aubrey. I'm gonna take you out on safari.
Safari!
The first evening, we went out on an afternoon safari looking for the lions. We drove around and then finally we found them. They were close to the dam wall, not far from Hanglep Mountain Lodge.
Oh my god. I can't believe our luck.
Pictures.
There's the fourth one. See the fourth one sticking out there?
Where? Oh, yeah. Ooh. It's another big one.
Wow.
Look up there, Jer.
We'll give everybody all these photos too.
Yeah, okay. If we make it out alive. They're just chasing each other.
We followed these lions until they come across Hanglep Lodge. That's where we started to see the action. They were actually keen to see if they can be success to make a kill.
Any station close to the radio, Wildside, any station, please stay inside. Inside the building, these guys are quite close to the building.
And hungry.
There were a group of wild beasts around the lodge, and these guys, they just started to spread themselves around the lodge itself and then position themselves to get ready to go for the wild beast. And then we set into that sighting until they react. They started to make action, like stalk this wild beast. I'm talking about inside the lodge. These lions were walking past the doors of the chalets at Hanglep Lodge. You could see them crawling, you know, heading towards where the wild beast were, and then doing the ambush style, like going both sideways to see if they can tackle this wild beast. Suddenly, while we're looking at this beautiful, you know, activity, there's one young female, I can say she was naughty. She interfered. She just, you know, ran over the fence and then ran towards the wildebeest, and the wildebeest could read or could tell that there is danger, and then all the wildebeest dispersed, and then the guys left with no kill that they made because of that young female. When we tell our guests that do not walk by yourself at night because there is dangerous animals in this area running in and out that can cause trouble to our clients, they don't believe.
Did you see what happened there, guys?
Yeah.
She but went and said, listen, get up, let's move on.
That's what she did.
Oh, her little bite?
Oh. Yeah, that little bite on the ear.
So what happened with the attack? Why did they fail?
I think the techniques they used, I think there's one female that went quickly before time.
Ah.
And then she just destroyed everything.
And it scared them off, huh?
Yeah.
He's relaxed after the big hunt.
Yeah. You really think we're going to step out after seeing those things?
Yeah, I know. Look out every window before we leave.
Everybody can jump.
Yeah.
Yes.
Nice.
Nice.
That feels good, huh?
After our first safari, I just can't wait for the next one. It was really exciting watching those lions hunt the wildebeest.
That's an easy find for
there
me.
There you go, huh?
Thank you. It's delicious.
Thank you.
Glad we're joining you guys
tonight.
Yeah.
Let's see what else.
You're the cause of it.
I know. My fault.
And because
blame
of
it
that,
on mom.
I never fed my children peas ever. Like, I will not do that.
Chain reaction.
Right?
This is some of the best.
Oh, it's delicious.
No.
It reminded me of that.
Maybe
helmeted guinea fowls. We were looking for elephant, and then we were on track, you know, following the fresh tracks. We drove in a sharp curve. There was a big female elephant charging, coming towards the vehicle. No, my baby, don't do that, sweetheart. I love you. Okay. Thanks, my sweetie. Right, we're fine. We're not bothering you. Go back. Thank you.
Good.
Wow.
Oh, good. I appreciate it.
You are shaking.
She's even 40.
I can't believe you. They listen like that.
They're very smart animals. Huh? Very, very smart. The one up front is a young boy. He's a very naughty guy. If we come close to the vehicle, the whole herd come and they thought we were giving him a hard time. Trunk of an elephant play a very, very important role in elephant society because they use that for most of the stuff. You again, Shiji. Give you lots of respect. I love you.
Is that a sign of affection?
No, it's just playing around. Nice shot. Oh my god.
Does the water ever dry up around here, Aubrey?
No, not at all. Always, there's always water, you know, through summer and winter. That's why the area itself is called Waterbeck.
Oh.
So it's lots of water. Even, I don't know if you've noticed, when we go up, some of the rocks are seeping water.
Yes, I noticed that.
Yeah. But if you look at one youngster on the right-hand side, she's got temporal gland. You see that looks like tears coming off?
Yes.
That's a temporal gland. That indicates the stressness they got. Maybe amongst each other. Or it could be they walked past the Laguan, you know Laguan? Water monitor. The small reptile that look almost like what? Crocodile.
Yeah.
There's one that she's a little bit not happy with us. Eh?
Scratching for something, that she's digging.
Yeah, sometimes they don't just feed on trees or leaves. They can feed on bulbs as well. So we've got lots of bulbs in the park. So if you see them scratching on the ground, they've maybe spotted a bulb or something. Look at the eyelashes, huh? Quite tall, and then they also don't have a good eyesight. They cannot see in a distance, but smelling is good as they use the trunk. If you throw that to me, that means she's not happy with me. That's what they do sometimes. Just pick up, break a little branch and throw that towards me. And then I have to back off and give her space. She doesn't feel very comfortable. That happened very often with me, especially you, Granny. I love you, do you know that? You're my best sister, okay? I love you. Don't panic. Be quiet, take pictures, no problem. Thanks, Granny. You can go off. My guests are not happy about you standing next to me. Thanks, my beauty. Thank you. Thanks, girl. Good girl. That's what you need to do with animals. Talk to them so that they can, you know, get used to know that. It's same with the lions, guys. If we do bushwalker on foot, and then we get shot, we talk to them, they stop and then turn around and move back. They really listen to us when we talk to them. While we were looking for this elephant, they end up disappearing. We lost the visual of them. And I just see these meetings of elephant dung, but they were old. I told my guest that you can use elephant dung as a medicine to heal the headache, or if you've got a nosebleed.
Right, and then after that, make sure you close with one hand like that, make a little tunnel, and you go.
Can I have a whiff of it?
Yes, why not?
Woo! Wow, that's better than wasabi.
Yeah. Nicholas?
I'm okay.
No, come on, you are.
Oh, yeah, that's great.
Did you do it?
Yeah.
If you have a headache or you have a problem with the nosebleed, let me know. Then I'll be your doctor. I'll be helping you. You'll be sniffing the elephant dung. We went out in the morning to go to look for cheetahs. And then we luckily found the tracks along the road while we're driving. And then we took it from there. Then I told them, this is fresh tracks. We're gonna track and see if we can be luck. And then off we went. While we're driving around, that's where we spotted these two blood brothers, very beautiful boys.
Don't move, just take pictures, otherwise they're gonna run away. They also got black spots, did you see them?
Look at the tail.
The tail as well, a bit of a white and a black spot that they use to find each other as well.
Oh.
Black marks behind the ears.
Like one.
Yeah. And then they even come up next to the vehicle and then even walk next to the vehicle, in front of the vehicle. I'm talking about not even a meter, walking by the vehicle. And the guys got the fantastic pictures that they took from those two blood brothers. They were so beautiful, they're beautiful cats.
They were quite close to Rick, huh?
Yeah.
They walked past Rick's eyes.
Right here.
Yeah, Rick. That was awesome, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't
want
to have to touch him. You have to separate him.
Yeah. Hello and welcome to Wildside. Come on in and I'll show you our private living space for the next 10 days. You'll notice this is not the honeymoon suite. In fact, they didn't even have us booked together in the same tent initially, but we got that straightened out. And the finest feature you'll enjoy is this electric blanket, much needed in this very, very cold night weather. So there we have our beds. We have our little dressing table here, Gideon Bible, of course. And a telephone that doesn't work. So Aubrey comes around every morning, 5:45. Hello, Rick and Barbara. Time to get up. Come on in and check out the bathroom. Here it is, the commode, if you will. Oops. And a shower, which has not seen use the last 3 days. There it is.
We're on the move now. We're heading up to the upper plateau. We're going to be driving onto a very special road that was made by the black women. There were about 28 women in 1998 when they started building this road. Beautiful road, and then when you go up, there was one area where it is so steepy, about 45 degrees. It's quite scary when you're coming down or going up. This route will lead you up all the way to the upper plateau, and then as you come around, when you clear the whole road, you see this beautiful, beautiful mountain in the middle of nowhere that is called Entabeni Mountain, which I said it means place of mountain. And then as you continue, you will see a lot of general game, even big five as well. You've got the wild beast, you've got the blessed bog, giraffes, and you've got rhinos, little baby rhinos as well, and a lot of warthogs. Amazing landscape. Well, the beast always will stick with the zebras because of the bad eyesight they've got. They know that zebras got all senses good. So if anything come within the area they are, and they will just get an indication from the zebras. Look at this, the pattern stripe on this female. Completely different to any zebra. It's got light white on the bump with no stripe some point, you know. Hello, boy. How are you, boy? Are you okay? Look at those small ears. Looks like my ears. Oh my gosh. See the feather that you see at the tip of the, or the tail feather. The one that most of the people use that as a feather dust, for a feather dust. We're going to do bushwalk there, and I don't know if they're going to have a problem with us, because these guys, they can chase, eh? Right, if you look at the terrain, guys, it will give you an idea what kind of animals do you expect here. So there's lots of tracks here. Tracks of the water. And this is a gnu. Wildebeest. This is the front part. The back part will be this size. Why? Anyone can tell. I did explain it. Because too much muscle on their shoulder. That's why wherever they stepped, you get a big tracks, and the back one, normal one. Look where we are now, on top of the mountain, about 1500 meters, eh? From the bottom up here. Look down there, beautiful view.
It's just been quite a day. Every day is quite a day.
Obviously, the bulls will be the one with the broader horns, bigger horns. Never seen a buffalo in the zoo. Because they need too much space.
How aggressive are they?
They can, very dangerous. All of them, they're coming for you.
Is that right?
Yeah, and if they get you nicely and stab you with that horn, they will lift you up. When you come back, you just die while you're on the way down. You're dead. Very powerful, very dangerous. That's why when you hunt a buffalo, you need to use two rounds.
What kind of noise do they make?
Come on, woo! Like dog, like turtles.
Oh yeah.
Come on, guys. Woo!
Look at him. Oh my gosh.
Woo!
Oh gosh.
Woo!
Yeah.
with those little Dutch wigs on you.
You making fun of us?
This is the white rhinos. We've got only one black rhino. This one went like a diet. Couldn't get up. See? Couldn't get up.
Wow. Don't make me.
I'll lie down next to you. White rhinos and then black rhinos, they're in trouble since a couple of years ago from the poachers. These guys poaching these beautiful animals, looking for the horns to make money out of it.
That's so sad.
Yeah, it's not a good thing. The guy is the stepfather. They don't know him. So that's why he's quite apart from them. When he always try to get close to them, they chase him off.
Really?
Yeah. Same thing happened down here. Same thing happened at the top. Yeah. Stepfather. He's not belong to this family.
Oh. So he's all on his own?
They will accept him in one of the good days.
Not today.
And they've been here for three months already with this family, but they didn't accept him yet.
Why is he rubbing his horn on the...
I think it's just getting a bit of a pain or something.
Oh, okay.
They're not a very pretty animal.
Leave my ears alone. But look at that little tiny one, that small one.
Where?
Like warthog.
Wow. Where?
Next to mommy.
Oh, I see.
Oh, isn't that very cute?
Very big warthog.
Very cute. It's a little baby hippo. Oh, there comes another one out.
Oh my goodness, yeah.
Yeah, and that little baby, it's a boy.
Oh.
Mommy, I'm just walking in front of you. Mommy, did you say when we are outside I can't drift on your back? No, you can walk with your legs. Okay, Mom. Let's go back into the water then. Oh, they were fighting. Look at that one, it's got wound. I think that was that noise they were making. So he got beaten. Oh my
God. Do they heal on their own or
get
infected?
No. They heal by themselves. Yeah. I see three. There's one already at the tree line.
Oh.
See, there's one approaching the tree line and one behind the bush and the big one there.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Look at the movement of the legs, guys. They almost move at the same time.
Now, is their defense running or kicking or?
Yeah, they can defend themselves by kicking forward, sideways, and backwards.
Oh, my gosh, is he gorgeous!
Have a look at the tip of his horns. It's got bald horns. The female will have tuft of hair at the tip of the horn. That's they help us to tell the difference between male and female. So always female got tuft of hair at the tip of the horns and the males got bald horns. And also the colors, of course. Dark male, females are lighter.
I want you to look at the binoculars. It keeps getting better and better, doesn't it? Oh, look how he runs.
He's kicking, huh?
Ha 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 ha! Jeff.
There you go.
Aww, it's a Jeff.
Hi, Jeff. Pick up the bone, bud.
Oh, it's a female.
Oh.
He likes to hop and skip.
All right, so we're out on track. We're tracking the lions. So we want to see lions. We tracked once and then we followed the lion tracks and then we found them finally up in the ridge.
Wow, after looking for them for so long.
You can see she's so massive. She's big, huh? And she's so beautiful.
Very big.
Yeah. Beautiful thing. I'm quite very lucky to work in this beautiful place called Entabeni Private Game Reserve. It's a beautiful place to come and view the game. Nice place to meet different people from different countries coming to view these beautiful animals here. What a beautiful place to view the game.
Babble la kayona, babble la kayona, babble la kayona.